So there's one thing I've wanted here at home pretty desperately for a long, long time.
Now brighten up everyone's day with a new wild and wacky singing, talking Louie the Largemouth Bass.
No, not that. I'm talking about a whole home hub, okay? Sort of a smart screen that has all my information in one place that I can see all the time. I kind of hope that we'd gotten there with the Amazon Echo Show. Now, if you remember, I did a video on that a while back and I was super excited about it. It's a fun toy, but just not a necessity. So enter the Lenovo Smart Display. So this is the first entry from Google with its Android Things platform. It's a display, it's smart, it gives you information and you can tell it to do things. And you know what? Looks pretty damn nice. So they sent me one and I've spent a week with it now. Does it live up to my expectations, my own self-hype? Let's go take a look. All right, you know what we do first here? Let's go do the basics. So the Lenovo Smart Display is actually the first in a series of devices like this. There are other manufacturers gonna make them too. So basically it's a Google Home with a touchscreen. Speaker, the display, microphones, camera, I mean pretty much everything you would expect in this sort of device, right? Now Lenovo actually has a couple of these, okay? They sent me the 10-inch model to check out and it's gorgeous. It's got matte white plastic with this really nice bamboo on the back. And the display is better than the smaller one we're gonna talk about in a second, okay? This one is $250. Now the smaller one is 8 inches and it's got a slightly smaller speaker and smaller display, yeah. And also a lesser resolution and that means fewer pixels per inch. Again, just a $50 difference. Now both sizes share a few other specs. 4 gigabytes of storage, 2 gigabytes of RAM, the 5 megapixel camera, and an 802.11 AC Wi-Fi. And both are powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 624 home hub platform. So let's talk about the buttons and switches for a second. You've got your typical volume rocker, and next to that, you've got a switch that turns off the mic if you decide you don't want the smart display to listen in on you anymore for you to tell it what to do. So right here, we have probably my favorite feature of any of the smart home devices with a camera that I've ever used. So Lenovo has put in a physical shutter switch to block the camera. Now, before we've always had to trust it, right? You say, turn the camera off, and you think it's turned the camera off, but do you really know? Well, here you just flip the switch and it's pretty obvious it can't see anymore. Every smart home device needs to have this. So as for the operating system, it's this relatively new thing called Android Things. So if you know Google Home and Chromecast, you can think of it as a good bit more than that, though it's also not like a full-blown version of Android, the operating system that you might, say, use on your phone. Let me just have Google explain it to you real quick.
So what is Android Things? Android Things is Google's managed operating system that enables you to build and maintain Internet of Things devices at scale. We provide a robust platform that does the heavy lifting with certified hardware, rich developer APIs, and secure managed software updates using Google's backend infrastructure.
So it's got the full weight of Google developers behind it, including long-term support for things like security and other functionality. And that's a big, big deal. All right, so here's the hard question. What the hell does this thing do? So let's start with the setup process. You're gonna use the Google Home app for that, either on Android phones or on an iPhone or an iPad. And yeah, that does mean that the Lenovo Smart Display ties into your Google account. So that means you'll be giving it access to things like your contacts for video calls or your calendar or just your whole Google knowledge graph of things you search for and things you want to do or eat or go or watch or whatever. But it is worth poking through the options in the Google Home app a little bit because that's where you're really gonna get a sense of everything else this can do. So let's start with the background, okay? It's what you're gonna see just kind of going on all the time when you're not actively using it. So it's called ambient mode and you can choose between some really great curated artwork or there are a couple of neat clock faces, I guess. But what I like to do when I get bored is just make up my own photo gallery of my own personal photos and then you have a digital photo frame. Nice. So let's talk about music for a little bit. You can tie in all sorts of accounts, right? Google Play Music, the new YouTube Music, Spotify, which is what I use. You can also just do Bluetooth if that's how you roll. So music is super simple. And remember, because this is a Chromecast target, anything it does, Chromecast works. And you can also pair it up with other Google Home devices around your house to have multi-room music. Very cool. So how's the speaker on the smart display? Look, it's not great, okay? It's perfectly fine for casual listening, like in the kitchen maybe, but it's absolutely nowhere near as good as, say, Sonos or Apple's HomePod. Now with video, things get a little more tricky. Here's what's going on. Now you saw in the setup, you can tie in things like your HBO account and CBS and stuff like that. You can just use your voice and tell it to play something on HBO or play something on CBS or whatever, and it just works. Voice also works really well for YouTube, obviously. You say, hey, watch Modern Dad on YouTube, it's gonna work. YouTube TV, though, doesn't work via voice. You're gonna have to use Chromecast to do that. So you start it from your phone and send it on over, and it works great. It's just one extra step. And this is true for some other streaming apps as well. PlayStation View, for instance, works perfectly. Things that do not work perfectly, Netflix. It won't actually send video over to the smart display. Can't do it with your voice, can't do it via Chromecast. Now, I asked Netflix about it and they said they have nothing to share at this time, which means they have nothing to share at this time. Don't know if they're gonna fix it or not. Some other things are broken too. DirecTV Now sends video, but not audio. And Sling tries, but just totally fails. So things are a little broken on that front. But if you use a service that actually works with it right now, it still makes it a really cool secondary display. Let's just hope, though, that they start fixing this stuff over time. So what else can you do with the Lenovo Smart Display? Well, basically think of anything you can do with a Google Home or a Google Assistant on your phone, and now you just have this big display to do it on. Well, I tell you what, I'll just have the Smart Display tell you what it can do.
This is the home screen, where you'll find notifications, reminders, and important information, and learn more about what your Google Assistant can do for you. Say hey Google to get started. You can ask questions, play your favorite music and videos, get step-by-step voice guidance for thousands of recipes, control smart home devices, and more. You can also ask your assistant to complete multiple actions with a single command. This is called a routine. Just say, hey Google, good morning. And your assistant will show you your calendar, the weather, your commute, and whatever else you need to start your day. Want to share the moment? You can video call friends and family hands-free with Google Duo, also built in on new Android phones and available for free on iPhones. You can connect compatible smart home devices like the lights and thermostat through the Google Home app on your phone. There you can set up news and media, customize routines, and change the ambient mode, which is what you'll see when you're not using your smart display. To adjust volume or brightness, swipe up from the bottom of the screen. And anytime you want to exit, just swipe from the left edge. Give it a try now and see what your smart display can do for you.
All right, one more cool thing you can do with this, video calls. And in fact, that's actually the only thing that the camera currently works with. And video calls themselves are pretty limited because you can only do it over Google Duo right now. Now that's actually not a horrible video calling app. Problem is nobody uses it, right? So if they're not using Duo and they're using say FaceTime or WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger or whatever, you're out of luck. You can only call somebody through Google Duo. But when you do it, it does work really well. And by the way, this is the only other time that you might flip it up and use the thing vertically. And in fact, it's the only thing that works vertically. I'm not gonna bother with that though. So that is the Lenovo Smart Display in a nutshell. And after a week of it, it's pretty clear it's gonna be a really cool device, I think. I've thought that before. But it's also very early in the lifespan of Android things. So we're gonna get more functionality over time. It's just a question of when. So should you buy it? Well, again, the 8-inch model at $200 is only $80 more than the old school Google Home. That's not bad for adding a display to the whole thing. And while it's gonna depend a good little bit on where you decide to put this thing, whether it's in the kitchen or your living room or even the bedroom, I think I might actually like that 8-inch size more. It just takes up a whole lot of real estate, especially if you're gonna try to put it on a kitchen counter. And you know, $250 for the 10-inch model, that's not inexpensive, especially for a first generation product. Even one this cool. And again, make no mistake, this is one of the very first products in the Android Things lineup. There will be more. They will get better. And in fact, this one's gonna get better too, I think. And look, I need it to get better, okay? Because a lot of the stuff that I still want a whole home hub to do, it just doesn't do yet, all right? I want my Nest doorbell to pop up automatically when somebody rings it. I want more video calling with services people actually use. I think Google will add more functionality as time goes on. It's just early days yet. So should you buy it? Maybe, just know what you're getting into, okay? It's definitely early, it's definitely gonna get better, and it's definitely not inexpensive. Now, is it better than the Amazon Echo Show? Well, I tell you, we're already running along here. That's gonna be a whole nother video, so stay tuned for that. Hey, by the way, be sure to subscribe, hit that little notification bell thing wherever it's at, so you'll be sure to see all the new videos, including the next one on the Echo Show. Go share this with all your friends. That's it, see you next time.